Growing crops here in the wet tropics usually involves a fair bit of paddock preparation with machinery. Apart from planting and harvesting equipment, most paddocks are worked up with a wide range of equipment to prepare the ground for your crop. The traditional approach is to use intensive tillage. This involves using equipment that aggressively works the soil to create soil structure, implements like rotary hoes. Intensive tillage also involves multiple passes across the paddock in the season. Using intensive tillage helps you to achieve three things. It helps to create soil structure or tilth so that your crops can establish and grow. It helps you to manage weeds, and it helps you to control trash or cover crop residues in the paddock. But in the mid to long term, intensive tillage can lead to some real problems in your soil. Firstly, it tends to pulverise your soil and you lose your soil structure. This means you need more tillage to get your soil structure back. This also leads to higher labour, machinery costs and more horsepower required.
My traditional approach was basically pretty conventional. The heavy clays were the hard ones to work. They dictated the most work. I would usually in the fallow disc two or three times, and then just before planting I'd disc twice, rip twice, and then hoe two to three, sometimes up to four times to get a fine tilt. And then I'd have an issue with moisture loss.
This paddock of cane behind me has been prepared using a different approach than intensive tillage. The grower has used minimum tillage, or min-till, for this crop of cane. A minimum till approach uses equipment that is much less aggressive on soil structure than traditional tillage. The aim with minimum till is always to look after soil health and soil structure.
The benefits of changing to this approach is less horsepower because I'm not working the whole paddock, I'm only working where I'm going to plant. Once it's on mounds with multi-species legumes, the soil health dramatically changes overnight.
Improving the structure, which you know gives me improved carbon retention, hopefully, which will help my nutrients be retained in my soil and not losing them as easily. It also gives me greater moisture holding capacity in dry times and freer drainage when it's wet. So the soil in that bed is not as waterlogged now as it used to be with those plant roots and all that organic matter in there.
There's no one size fits all when it comes to min-till. There's a range of equipment that you can use, and it'll depend on your farm and your soil type as to what'll work. You often need to customise gear to work for your place as well. You need to think about what type of planting equipment you're going to use, bed preparation and your bed management. And you also need to think about what type of gear you can use to manage crop residues and cover crop biomass.
This is a small renovator recycled out of a returning disc. Ideal for small farmers that does one row at a time, but capable of doing 30 acres a day. So preparation is not really a problem at 10 kilometres an hour.
Under my new minimum tillage approach, we simply spray out the plough out cane crop. We zero till legumes and sunflowers into that. And then in March, we come in with the wavy disc cultivator with a seeder on it, and we plant a second cover crop. From there, I'll work this twice with the bed renovator, and then we'll plant cane in that with the planter. This is my min-till planter. It's a traditional stick planter. It has double disc openers, dual row. The dual rows are at 500 mils apart.
These days, my main piece of equipment on the property is this heavy-duty bed renovator. I use it to prep the ground, get rid of the trash, plough out and prepare the ground for planting as well. So I have one basic piece of equipment.
This paddock was planted zero till. I made a crimping roller up. Yeah, this is my roller crimper. A lot of research on the net and looking on the Rodale Institute, and I come up with this design. This mounts onto the rear axle of the tractor, which lays the cover crop down all that direction as you're planting. And then double disc openers, it goes straight through because everything's laying the right way for it. It's still anchored to the ground so it won't bulldoze and just flows straight through. It works a treat, and especially if you've got good soil structure. If you've pulverised it the year before, well, you may get some troweling on the sides, but by putting some mixed species in there and improving the structure, It's just nice and crumbly and everything flows beautiful.
Min till leads to less soil disturbance, and this has real benefits for your farm. It basically means better soil structure, better root volume, better nutrient management, and better aeration and water drainage in your paddocks. It also means less horsepower, labour and machinery costs in the long term.
The major benefits I've seen from min-till is a really obvious one, is the cost. It's much reduced on my past practices. I'm bloody happy with it, yeah.
If you want to have success with min-till, there's a couple of things that you really need to think about. Firstly, min-till's really not going to be effective and give you benefits if you don't also implement controlled traffic farming, or CTF, keeping wheel tracks and growing zones separate at all times.
Farmers who wish to change to minimum till approach, the first thing I would say is sit down and work out your row spacing. That is something that once you've got it, you're basically stuck with it. You can customise your minimum till machinery to suit every situation and your farm size, so we're not all stuck in the same box. Before you go in, you have to make sure your soil moisture is right, especially in the heavy clays. Don't jump the gun. If you do, you'll pay the penalty. And that's what happens when you work wet.
Yeah.
Looks like plasticine.
So I think if you're thinking about changing to minimum tillage, I think the tips would be that you need to be growing a cover crop, because that gives you the good soil structure and you don't need to work your soil much afterwards. And secondly, your timing, and you don't want these cover crops like this one drying your soil out too much to put cane in, so you have to monitor that.
And finally, you may have to go out into the paddock at times of year that you're not used to. If you want to learn more about min-till and how to implement it on your place, then get in touch with your local extension officer, Terrain NRM, or follow the links at the end of this video.